It is game day in Montreal as the Ottawa Senators pay a visit to the Bell Center for the eighth meeting this season between the Senators and Canadiens. Montreal playing their second game in 24 hours after earning an important 2-1 win over the Calgary Flames Friday night at home. Meanwhile, Ottawa coming off a 3-2 loss to the Jets. And today, all eyes on Shane Pinto making his NHL debut, which means the good old solo lap.
Hey, kid, you're here for a reason. So whatever it is that got you here, just do that and you'll be fine. And like that's the message that Shane Pinto should take into this game. Whatever it is that he does well, whatever the foundational pieces of his game are, whether that's good defensive play, smart plays with the puck, aggressive with your shot, whatever it is that you do well, just do that. You'll do fine.
Thank you, Lindsay. Good afternoon and welcome to Montreal as the Canadiens play host to the Ottawa Senators, the eighth meeting of the year. Ottawa won the last one 6-3, a decisive win for the Senators, and another new look for Ottawa tonight as Shane Pinto makes his NHL debut. Pinto, the 20-year-old from Franklin, New York, spent 2 years at North Dakota. He was the Conference Player of the Year this season, a finalist as well for the Hobie Baker Trophy as the top player in college hockey.
The Sens are excited. I'm excited. He's excited. We've been waiting to see Shane Pinto. We've heard a lot about him over the last year. He played so well in college. He achieved everything that you can achieve. He's ready to take the next step, and that next step starts today.
Kotkaniemi facing off against Josh Norris. And Shane Pinto out there wins the faceoff on his first National Hockey League shift. Zaitsev plays it around. Back at the point, Connor Brown with a shot. He powdered that wide. Carey Price, the screen. Picked up now by Josh Anderson. Anderson, lead pass for Jonathan Drouin. That was knocked away by Nikita Zaitsev. Now a pass through the middle. Anderson centers it. Here is Pinto. Up ahead for Dzingel. Pinto got spilled at center ice. Romanov back to pick it up. And off the bench, Kotkaniemi lays that back for Edmondson. Then Kotkaniemi sweeps it back down to the Ottawa zone. Anderson tied up by Brännström. Jonathan Drouin, mired in a miserable 23-game goalless drought, plays it back for Anderson. A bouncing puck, and that's backhanded down the ice by Pinto, who's out there on the Montreal penalty kill.
Beautiful. Learn on the fly. He knows what he's supposed to do. You're a smart player. You can figure it out as you go. It's not that complex.
Anderson moves in, drops it back. Kotkaniemi's pass is picked off, and Pinto sees that and sends it down.
Now, okay. I'll get you another shift in the PK.
One thing we've noticed about Pinto, he's got the very wide blade in his stick.
It is a boat oar for a blade.
So let me take a closer look at Shane Pinto, who was terrific at North Dakota, especially this year. 15 goals in 28 games, was named the NCHC Player of the Year and Defensive Player of the Year. They were knocked out in quintuple overtime by Minnesota Duluth in the NCAA playoffs, which freed up he and Jacob Bernard Docker. And so Pinto turns pro and disappointed a little bit that his parents didn't come up to Montreal for the game, but here's his work on the penalty kill.
Yeah, and I think he's slowing down a little bit, not in the way he skates, but in his reading the play. First couple shifts, he was flying everywhere, trying to be on every check, stop every rush, be on every situation. Now he's just letting the game come to him a little bit more. Good patience and read there by Pinto on the penalty kill. See how many points Stützle has when he's 25.
In comes Pinto across the line. Shane Pinto works in and shoots. He fired that wide. And Edmondson back for the loose puck. Four to go here. Petrie. Pass broken up. Boy, that thick blade does well
it
for
is.
Pinto, doesn't it?
Like, think of Paul Stastny has a blade similar in the NHL currently.
Tamu Solani had one like that.
I know mine was illegal. It was too tall when I played. Absolutely. So I know all about it.
So Mike Johnson confessing to a crime now.
But it's amazing. You know, it looks big out there. It knocks it down. It settles it quick. And another good read. And you're talking about baby steps. And in your first game, you latch on to anything positive. You knock a puck down. Great play. You handle a pass clean. Great play. You make a proper read on a neutral zone. Fantastic. You try someone one-on-two. You love it. You love to see the confidence of a player not just giving it away every time he gets it on his stick.
And Mike Johnson, that first period, saw Ottawa showcase Shane Pinto in his National Hockey League debut, and he looked pretty good.
Well, since he might not be able to remember it all, because it's all a bit of a blur for him, we'll show him what he did in that first period. And starts with a pregame warm-up. Of course, we know you get out there, you get to wheel around by yourself, fire one way high and wide, beat the glass down a little bit, but you know, take your regular shift, You're nervous, your legs aren't there, but a kind word from a veteran. Thank you very much, Connor Brown. I appreciate that. And as the period got going, he got better. You could see him finding the little quiet spaces to be available defensively. You can see the reliability of not blowing the zone, the strength in his stride, which I like to see. And DJ Smith using him on the penalty kill. That shows a little bit of confidence, which makes you feel a little bit better about yourself as you go along. So all good until the very end where he eats Corey Perry's stick. And he's checking the nose. Welcome to the NHL. No more cage. Watch your face. And looks like he came out of that first period a little worse for wear. If you're not bleeding, you're not trying, Gord.
First NHL goal against Carey Price. Nifty move there by Pinto.
Number one offensive centerman after showing so well in the bubble and has had his moments, but not the consistency that he's looking for.
Pinto won that draw cleanly from Kotkaniemi. It bounces back in front. Down 2-0 to Ottawa. The team that's had your number all year. Now Pinto out there. Flip that just wide.
I thought maybe Shane Pinto getting back on the ice. Only had a few shifts in the second period, but I've never seen Shane Pinto play or call the game other than just watching him on television. And I like his anticipation. I like, you know, he's in the right spots. And I also like the power in his stride. You can tell when guys are quick. It doesn't take long. That guy's a good skater or not, and he looks like he's a good skater.
But his feet does a 720 at center ice. That pass picked off by Pinto. Drops it back to Tkachuk with a long shot. That goes wide. Well, Shane Pinto's been picking off pucks all afternoon. And now comes back on Kulak, which is not easy. Again, Kulak, a top-end skater.
Down the stretch to Montreal now.
Well, if you ask Montreal and Calgary why they're in this race for fourth place, it's their record against Ottawa. They've both struggled against the Senators this year.
And I think...
Oh, empty net score!
Bango! I like it! Take it and center cut for... You know what? Good on Zaitsev. One draw. First point for Shane Pinto.
Yes.
I love it on a one draw in the defensive zone. Go get that puck. Why not? But the assist is nice. The fact that he's out there taking a defensive zone faceoff.
Right.
And he's been good on the draws. He has been solid and strong defensively, which will allow you to grow into your offensive game. DJ Smith will get you on the ice if you're not going to hurt him as you figure out how to help him offensively.
He's won 4 of 6 faceoffs. He's taken the game now. Centering pass. High chance there for Lekkonen. Good stop by
Shane Pinto, first point. Solid game. Looks like he is a keeper. Lots to like about this one for Ottawa.